Mind Your Decisions, I'm Presh Talwalkar. A mathematician writes numbers on a cube. On each face, the mathematician writes a positive integer. For clarification, a positive integer is a whole number greater than zero. On each vertex, the mathematician writes the product of its three adjacent faces. For example, in the upper right corner, the mathematician would write the number that's equal to the product of x, y, and z. The mathematician does this for each of the vertices. If the sum of all vertices is 154, what is the sum of all faces? A similar problem was asked to 8th grade students in Taiwan, who were aged roughly 13 to 14 years old. I thank Kieran in New Zealand for the suggestion. Pause the video if you'd like to give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching to learn how to solve this problem. So how can we solve this problem? Suppose the faces are labeled A, B, C, D, E, and F. Suppose the face we're looking at is labeled A. We'll rotate the cube to label the faces B, C, and D. We'll rotate the cube again to get back to A. On the left side, we'll label it as E, and we'll label the face on the right as F. Let's now label each vertex. This vertex will be labeled A, B, E. Then, if we rotate the cube, this vertex will be labeled ABF. Let's continue doing this for all the vertices. Now, on the bottom, we have the face D, and on the left side, we have E. We still have D on the bottom, and on the right side, we have F. So we can label these two vertices. They will be ADE and ADF. Let's put these labels to the side, and now let's label the remaining four vertices, which will be on the opposite side of the cube. So we'll look at face C, and we'll label each of these vertices. On the left side will be E, and on the right side will be face F. On the top of this will be face D, and on the bottom of C will be face B. We can use these labels to label each of these vertices. Starting from the lower left and going clockwise, we have CBE, CDE, CDF, and CBF. We want the sum of all of the vertices. Let's sum the first four and the second four separately. The first four we can factor out an A, and the second four we can factor out a C. Notice the remaining bracketed terms are exactly equal in both of these equations. So we can further factor the sum as A plus C multiplied by the bracketed term. Let's continue factoring. The first two terms here have a common factor of B. The next two terms have a common factor of D. We then have a common factor of E plus F. So we get the following factorization for the sum of all these vertices. It'll be A plus C multiplied by B plus D multiplied by E plus F. Now recall, this is equal to 154. Since each number is a positive integer, each bracketed term must be 2 or larger and must be a factor of 154. 154 factors into 2 times 7 times 11. Therefore, the three bracketed terms must be equal to 2, 7, and 11, and the sum of the bracketed terms will be the sum of 2, 7, and 11. Therefore, we have A plus C plus B plus D plus E plus F is equal to 2 plus 7 plus 11. Now, if we look at these bracketed terms, we have one of each letter. Therefore, we have the sum of the faces, and this is equal to 20. And that's the answer. The sum of the numbers on the faces is equal to 20. What a neat little problem. Thanks for making Mind Your Decisions one of the best channels on YouTube. As always, thanks for watching, and thanks for your support.